Hello, my name is Stéphane Faou. I'm a French database consultant and a database book author. I'd like to present a brief introduction to database design by showing you, on a small example, some issues you can encounter and some ways to solve them. For my example, I'd like to create a website that provides information about movies. You are probably aware that in a database, data is stored in tables. We'll obviously have some kind of movies table inside our database. Tables in a database are very different from spreadsheets, but let's start with a spreadsheet that contains information about a small number of classic movies. Title, country, year, director, and leading actors. Initially, we shall model our main table after the spreadsheet. Each row brings together a number of pieces of information that are the characteristics of a movie. The order of columns doesn't matter. The order of rows doesn't matter. What matters is that the different pieces of information on one row are related, and the titles of the columns define the relation. This is why we talk about relational databases. It makes no sense to have the same row several times. An important step when designing a database consists in identifying the characteristics that allow us to distinguish one movie from another, and very often, these characteristics are a subset of all the characteristics.
They are collectively called
the key. What is the smallest subset of characteristics that uniquely identifies a movie? The title? No, the title isn't enough, because you have remakes. For instance, there are several movies based on the Treasure Island novel. Title and director, perhaps. It doesn't work either. Because Alfred Hitchcock, for instance, made two The Man Who Knew Too Much, one in 1934 and the other one in 1956. Title, director and year may seem a better choice, except that director isn't as simple characteristics as it may look. Some movies have several directors, and it may lead to ambiguities. Title, country and year look reasonable. It is very unlikely, not least for commercial reasons, that two movies with exactly the same title will be produced the same year in the same country. It is sometimes possible to find several groups of characteristics that uniquely identify a row in a table. You are free to choose the group that you find the most convenient as the main identifier, and this group of characteristics is called the primary key. The ultimate goal of all databases is to be queried. That means that people will search the table using some interface to retrieve movies that satisfy some particular conditions. Behind the scene, the program will issue an SQL query in which you name the characteristics you want, followed by the name of the table, followed by filtering conditions. And here, we have several problems. If we want to retrieve all the movies that were directed by one given director, it is essential that the condition exactly matches the contents of the table, that is, that if the row has for director attribute Hitchcock, comma, A, dot, the filtering condition is exactly entered as Hitchcock, comma, A, dot, not as Hitch or Hitchcock, and definitely not as Alfred Hitchcock. There is also a consistency issue with data that will probably be entered by different people at different times and must respect the same conventions. If you say that North by Northwest and Rear Window are Hitchcock, A. movies, while Strangers on a Train is an Alfred Hitchcock movie, users who query the database will have much trouble getting the full list of Hitchcock movies. As a general rule, character fields that are freeform text call for trouble when they are used for searches. This is true for directors, and this is true as well for the leading stars. We must therefore define some kind of standard for storing names. Storing first name and surname separately, and it can be a good idea to define the standard case, uppercase for instance. Standardization is a first step in the right direction. But we still have a few number of problems to solve. The first one is typos. A user who mistypes a name may realize the mistake, check the spelling and try again. But if there are some misspellings in the database, information that is misspelled will only be found by users doing the same mistake when they query, not a desirable situation. Let's ditch this model. And let's try a new one.